Welcome to episode 19, right, of the Madcast. It's Tuesday, not Thursday, sorry. It's Tuesday for me. Today we're having a Big Ben Porter. Pub owners near the London port and train stations were known many years back to serve local porters as cheap mix made of two or three brews that they could not sell. Local brewers then created a beer named Entire that included the main profile of the mix, brown, malty, slightly sweet with a touch of burnt caramel flavor and not too strong in alcohol. It was the ideal, inexpensive beverage to replenish one's energy without taking the time to have a full meal. It became the Porter's beer. In remembrance of this era, we created our Big Ben Porter, moderately dry, with flavors of slightly burnt caramel malts. The English hops are bringing a light bitterness to balance it all. Give it a little stir, you know? All right. So we're having the Big Ben Porter. This porter actually won in 2012 the World Beer Awards for the world's best stout and porter. So yeah. We're drinking, and this is the International Dota Championships Pub Stomp 2014 glass. You can't see it real well because, you know, whatever. In the back of the glass, there's all the like 16 teams' names or whatever. And in front, there's the logo and the name. Because right now it's the finals. Actually, it's Monday. I could have filmed this tomorrow. Oh, well, too late. It's actually Monday, it's not Tuesday. I fucked up. I'm all fucked up in the head. Because today is the grand finals of the international. So they're playing right now. Newbie versus Vici Gaming. They're both like Chinese team, Asian teams. And so far Vici won game one. Spoiler. So I don't think Newbie are going to win. Vici are pretty strong. Anyways. So yeah, I went to a pub stomp Saturday. And I got a t-shirt that I'm not wearing right now because it's in the washing machine. And I won a pint glass, so pretty neat. Alright. This is a 5.5% alcohol Big Ben Porter. Then that's a lot of beer. I'm probably not gonna finish this, by the way. Just a heads up, I'm probably gonna finish like half and drink it later. Because I don't have time. I need to study, actually, but I don't know. Alright, it's getting a lot of burnt caramel tastes. It tastes a lot like a stout. Well, porters and stouts are pretty similar. Tasting a bit of coffee in there. I don't hate it, but I don't like it really good. It tastes really strong for a 5% alcohol, you know? Pretty good though, it's pretty good. So yeah, the pub stomp. Actually I have pictures. I'll show some pictures. Here's some pictures. I actually took some pictures on my phone. It was in Ottawa, the nearest one. It wasn't like a sort of like arcade, like a midway kind of thing, like a, you know, you play like I don't know, like, do you play arcade machines, but they're not like Mortal Kombat, like, I don't know, like the usual arcade machines, they're the ones that you play a game and you win tickets. So you had like a card and you swiped it and you got tickets and you could redeem your tickets for like candy and stuff. For like $20, I think the event was like you paid $10 and you got like you got into the event. You got a raffle ticket, and for $20 you had like a pizza slice, a beer, a $5 arcade card, and like a raffle ticket. So yeah, actually I bought more raffle tickets to have a chance of winning, and I'm glad I did, because I only won once, and I got this fine glass here, so. Cheers. So yeah, it was really fun. It was a pretty nice big room with maybe like 6 rows of like 12 chairs. And you know, there was like a bar with like pizza and shit, and a projector with a big screen with the games playing. It was basically just a Twitch stream, but it was fine. Back in the back, it had like a 1v1 setup thing, so you could pay $5 to play in the 1v1s. And I played a 1v1 with my friend Big B, and I won. Get wrecked, scrub, and we each won like a t-shirt from playing the 1v1, so it was pretty worth it. And also, from the 1v1, when you won, that's a lot of ones, you got a t-shirt and a coupon for a free game of your choice. It was like, there's like, it's a AMD thing rewards or some shit, and you go on their website and you enter the code and they give you like about 6 choices of games to get. I got Total War Shogun 2 because I've always wanted to try it, and the other ones I already played them, so I got that game. I will probably not play it because I suck at those kind of games, but you know, that was the only one that was interesting me, so I got it for free. So, well, free anyways, that was pretty cool. They were great games, and yeah. I'm just gonna move on to emails right now, because why not? You know what I'm saying? Alright, first off, we got an email here from Greg. Gregorino. He says, Marty, please be my hero and make a phase montage of you drinking your beer. Thanks. Illuminati man. So that's kind of a montage parody, right? All right. Here's to you, Greg.
Pass me the Mountain Dew. And what is this song?
That's not a chugging beer. Woo. That's like drinking syrup. Tastes good, but
man,
it's harsh. Alright, so there you go, Greg. Hope you enjoyed it. That's it. Next email. From fucking Hubert Cumberdale. Do the biggest burp ever. Alright. Alright. That wasn't too bad. All right, take two. All right, I can do better, but I'll save that for later, you know, or something, whatever. Question, he says, drink hot milk. No, I won't, because hot milk's gross. Stick your nose into your beer. Spit into the fan. Nope. Do you like French courses? No, I don't. Because fuck that. What's the best book you've read? All right, that's an actual question. Yay! Great job. The best book I've read, I haven't read many, but that's actually a good question. I think it was in high school, like secondaire 5 or 4. It's not a badass if it doesn't crash. By the way, it just crashed and I just made the biggest burp. So fuck. Fucking goddamn it. Of course when I burp, it cuts out. Whatever. Best book I've read, it's probably in Scholar 4 or 5. It's a book called Malice, I believe. It was a big red book, and it's like kind of a book, like normal reading book. And slash comic, so there's like comic elements, because basically the story is there's three kids, like teenagers, and they hear about like a ritual about this comic book, that if you do the ritual you get into the book and you know you don't come back, you know. So they do the ritual, and there are three two guys, one girl, and they go into the comic book. And like they do, like there's like obstacles and shit. It's like a really really nice cool world, you know. It's kind of like steampunky, and they're like inside the comic book, and there's one of their friends that's reading it, and they're in it, and they're like, oh shit, blah blah blah. And so yeah, it's kind of like they go into the comic book and they have to get out, some kind of shit. There's two books in the series. I haven't finished the second one because I was too lazy. Sorry. So I don't know how it ends. If you know, send me an email at mario20kid@love.com. Send me an email and tell me how it ends. Because I'm too lazy to not buy it, but read it. And I think I lost the second book, so. That was a really good book. What's the color of your pee this morning? Kind of bright yellow, I'd say, because I drank lots of beer yesterday. Usually beer makes like white piss, you know, but yeah, it was kind of yellow, you know, usual. No solid loaves, alright, sorry. Scream like hell. No, thanks. I was screaming Saturday. I screamed a lot because it was like fucking Dota, woo! But no, I'm not gonna. Sorry. All right. Can I see who sent this email? All right. All right. We've got a new emailer here, and I think I know who it is. From the boss. Number one, question number one. Do you like to dip clown wigs in barbecue sauce? I love barbecue sauce, but I don't like clown wigs. What's your favorite kind of cheese? Cheddar. Feta cheese is pretty good, like in salads and stuff. Mozzarella's good on pizza. But I'd say cheddar. What is your favorite special infected in Left 4 Dead? I'd say classic Left 4 Dead, Left 4 Dead 1. I'd say the Boomer, because that one's fucking awesome. You know, classic. But for Left 4 Dead 2, I'd say the jockey. I won't make a sound, because I can, but I won't, because fuck that. The jockey's really funny. So, there you go. Ding! Number four, would you like to live in space if it wasn't dangerous? Of course, man. It's fucking space. Space Colony HD. Space Engineers. Space Base DF9. Edge of Space. Terraria? No, Starbound. Starbound's okay. Yeah. But I really like to live in space. You know, it'd be scary, because if you just go like without a jetpack, you just fly away for eternity. But yeah, space would be cool. I think we won't really have a choice in the near future, because Earth is gonna be so polluted or some shit. Something is gonna happen. We're gonna be forced to live on another planet someday. And also the airspace, like the out of the ozone, there's so many debris that I don't know, man. I don't know. Five. Do you live
in a dangerous neighborhood? You're scared for the safety of your family, friends, and trees.
I don't live in a dangerous neighborhood. As I know of, I don't know. I'm not really scared. No, I'm good. Number six, don't forget to eat healthy cheese and cheddar. All right, thank you very much, the boss. Thanks for emailing those questions in. I don't have any news prepared this week because it's my finals week and I've been working every day for like 7 days, and it's my finals in French and it's the finals in Dota, so I don't have time. Sorry. So I hope you enjoyed this week's episode. I haven't finished the beer because it's 500 milliliters, and finishing that in like 15 minutes is a lot to ask for, so excuse me. Follow us on Twitter, twitter.com/beerandduke. Like us on Facebook, facebook.com/thebackass. Or send me an email, marty20k@live.com. marty20k@live.com. That's my email. Send me an email. Sorry, I done that. Preferably send me like actual questions, please, and not like statements or like, you know, facts. send me like the book reading one was pretty good. Shout out to Hubert. That was a good question. Out of like 12. Yeah, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next week with hopefully. Oh, hello. Cut tape, restart, rewind. Thanks for watching. Hopefully next week we'll be more organized and well, it will be. There's no question about it, because I won't have summer school anymore next week. Whoop whoop! 2 weeks of no school until school starts again. Hype! So yeah, thanks for watching for the third time, if you're still watching, and I'll see you next week. Oh, shit.